My name is Jeremiah. I'm an undergraduate at UC Santa Cruz. I'm a third year, and I joined the lab just a few weeks ago, actually. So we study mammalian cortical development is our main focus, and we focus a lot on neural stem cells. And the cortex is the part of the brain that kind of makes you you, where you think about things. And it's a really complicated structure, and there's a lot of interest in how that develops and how neurons decide which part of the cortex to go to. And there's a lot of interest in stem cell therapeutics for brain injury. But I'm really just curious in how the brain actually evolves and how all of that comes together. I grew up in Mill Valley, California. It's in Marin, just north of San Francisco. I don't come from a scientific family at all, actually. When I was in high school, I was in physiology, and I became interested in the human body, and I thought, oh, I'd really like to be a physician. And as time went on, I did an internship in a hospital, and I worked in a research lab at UCSF. And I actually came to the conclusion that I really did not want to be a physician, and that the lab is where I wanted to be. I was a lot more interested in kind of discovering how all of these things work, and I guess treating people just wasn't for me. It seemed like people were really following their interests and finding something they were interested in, just pursuing it and doing, you know, finding everything they could about it. And it kind of seemed like doctors were just overworked and exhausted. I hate to say it, but that was the general vibe I got. So I thought, you know, A, I want to just pursue something I'm interested in, and B, it might not be the job for me. First time you go into the lab, it looks quite overwhelming and futuristic. There are a lot of huge expensive machines around. There are a bunch of people. You'll see a lot of people that seem like they're walking fast, trying to get stuff done. And there are a lot of shelves with all these chemicals and things you've never seen before. And the first time you go in a lab, it's a pretty exciting and somewhat overwhelming experience. But then as you are in the lab more and more, it starts to feel surprisingly familiar. A lot of time, you know, fiddling around with machines, and I work with these microelectrode arrays that record signals from live neural tissue. So some of that is working with technology like that, data analysis, and just a lot of general lab work. There's always collaboration going on. All the labs are on one open floor, so just day to day there's a lot of cross communication. On top of pursuing my interests, which is how do neurons talk to each other, what's happening, and how does the brain develop, that's kind of the big picture inspiration. And then day to day, being in the lab is just an enjoyable experience. It's always productive, it's familiar, you go in there, you know what you're doing, and it's just it's a nice thing. Well, if you're young, just keep doing what you're interested in, because your interest will help you succeed. I was never a great student in high school, and once I discovered that I wanted to do biological research, I began working hard and learning because I wanted to. And then ever since then, I've been an exceptional student. But before then, I was pretty average. So I would say, find something that interests you, even if there's no immediate goal, you know, graduate, get a job, make money. If there's something that interests you, and it interests you a lot, then I would say pursue that. And it'll take you somewhere you didn't expect.